Hey, what is going on, guys? This is Jonathan Ferrell, and today I want to show you guys how to add users into your GoHighLevel account. Now, it's very easy to do so, and typically what we can do is once we've added a user, we can assign them specific permissions. So what you'll do is you'll navigate to the Settings tab on the left, and there is a section right here that says My Staff. You can go ahead and click on the My Staff button. And that will allow for you to add users into the account. Now you'll see that I have an agency account. This person has access to the agency as well as the account. And then we also have the account admin. And this person only has admin access to the account itself, so they cannot access anything within the agency. However, they are an admin of the specific sub-account. So what we're going to do is we're going to add an agency user to this account. This person only has specific permissions that have been assigned to them, and you do so by clicking the Add Employee button right here. Now, in this person, we're going to go ahead and assign their name. And just need to assign them with their email. And that will go ahead and get their account created. And what you will do is you're going to navigate to this roles and permission setting. And what you will also want to do is you want to make sure that you add them specifically to the role that they need to be. So, for instance, if they are a user, we want to go ahead and select the user tab. And then the data visibility scope, we want to go ahead and select the only assigned data. Now, what that means is they can only see contacts that they are assigned to as the owner or a follower. They will not be able to see any other contacts inside of the system. So this is really great for sales teams, especially if you're using one sub account and have multiple sales agents. They can only see the data that is assigned to them. You'll also see right here that you can navigate the account settings, so you could turn on or off account settings individually or one by one. Excuse me, one by one or by grouping them. And you might want to also disable their view manage campaign settings. Typically, whenever I set somebody up, I'll show you how I get them set. Especially from a sales team, we want to disable blogs, automations, account tools. We do want them to view the calendars. We could disable certificates, disable communities. We can have them view and manage contacts, and they will be able to view and manage bulk actions. Now, they will not be able to export their contact list, just so you know, but they will be able to see and perform bulk actions like adding tags or sending mass emails to their assigned contacts. Okay, we do want for them to maintain the conversation piece. We can have them see the dashboard. I typically remove anything pertaining to like phone call stats or agent reporting, any of that other kind of stuff. Typically, what I like to do is have them be able to view the dashboard, disable funnels, disable integrations, and we want to disable some of these other marketing pieces as well. Okay, we could disable media, membership. We'll have them basically access their sales pipeline, which is opportunities, and then we can disable payments depending on if they need to take payments or not. Okay, they don't need access to reviews, don't need access to WordPress, and then we can click on the Save button. Now, again, just like I said, this person will now only have access to the data that has been assigned to them. They will only have access to these features which we have enabled for them. And this is good permissions that we utilize for any person who is in a sales role. Again, they'll only be able to see the contacts that have been assigned to them, and they only have user permission settings within the sub account. Okay, so I hope this video helps, especially for setting up a sales team. If you have any questions, please feel free to reach out to me. We'd love to help you out with any other questions. Thanks. Bye.